Hello and welcome to Storytime. My name's Sarah and I'm a part of LifeChurch Brackley, and we as a church are so excited to be able to put this on for you. So Storytime is a time where we're going to have a story read to us, and then someone's going to show us a craft that we can do with things found in our house. So why don't you get comfortable, maybe grab a snack if that's allowed, and enjoy hearing Nathan read us our story today, and then Tara will do a craft for us to watch and maybe join in with later.
Today, we're going to read the story of the sower. Jesus was a great storyteller. People came from miles around to hear his stories about God and his kingdom. His stories were about ordinary things, but they made people think and ask questions. One day, as the crowd listened, Jesus pointed to a farmer in a nearby field. People turned to look. The man was sowing seeds as he walked up and down the field. So Jesus told them a story about a sower. One evening, a farmer said, "The field is ready. It's time to plant my crops." Early next morning, he filled a big bag full of grain seeds, slung it over his shoulder, and set off to his field. Slowly and steadily, the farmer trudged up and down his ploughed field. Handful by handful, he threw seeds into the air. Where did the scattered seeds fall? Some seeds landed nearby, others were carried away by the breeze. The seeds fell here and there. The farmer didn't notice where. He would find out when the seeds grew shoots. Some seeds fell on the footpath where people trod on them, and then greedy birds swooped down and gobbled them all up. Some seeds fell on stony ground. The seeds began to grow, but they needed water. Soon their tiny shoots drooped and died in the hot sun. Some seeds fell among thorns. The seeds put down roots and grew strong shoots, but the thorns were stronger and choked the little plants. But some seeds fell on good, rich soil. They made deep roots and grew big green shoots. The farmer was pleased to see these strong new plants. Maybe the harvest will be good, he thought. At last, harvest time came. "It's time to cut the crop," said the farmer. He and his helpers worked all day to harvest the golden ears of wheat. And every plant made lots of new seeds, 100 times more seed than the farmer had sown. "But what does the story mean?" asked one of Jesus' friends. "The seeds are what God tells us about his kingdom," said Jesus. Some people don't really listen. So God's message is snatched away like the seeds gobbled up by the birds. Some people are glad to hear what God tells them, but as soon as trouble comes, they are just like the plants that drooped and died. Some people hear and gladly accept God's teaching. Then their life gets too busy and their understanding does not grow. That's like the seeds that fell among the thorns. But some people really listen and understand what God wants. They are like the seeds that fell on good soil and the plants that made more new seeds. They do as God asks, and their lives show amazing results. And that's the end of our story.
Oh, thanks, Nathan. I really enjoyed listening to that story read to us. Now, I don't know if you've ever thought about God or this guy called Jesus before, but this story encourages us, doesn't it? It encourages us to have a little bit of a think of who he is and what that means. So now Tara is going to show us a craft that we can do with things in our house. And this craft is a craft that involves seeds, just like in the story we heard.
Well, hello. I hope you've enjoyed listening to that story Now we're going to plant some cress seeds. So what you'll need for that is a pot. So I've got one here. Now, if you haven't got a pot, you could use a yogurt pot, a plastic cup, or if you're like me and you like some boiled eggs in the morning for breakfast, you could keep your eggshell and pop a little vase on, like I've done like so, and you could plant into an eggshell. Now what we're going to use is some cotton wool balls, or you can use cotton wool pads, or if you haven't got those, then kitchen towel is equally as good. If you're using kitchen towel, fold it into squares and pop it right down into your cup. I'm going to use a second one, just so that it's a nice cushion for the seeds to sit on. I'm just going to pop some cotton wool balls in here now. I'm just going to add some water to make the kitchen towel nice and moist, ready for the seeds to sit on top of. And again, for the cotton wool. And then we're going to add our seeds. So you just need some cress seeds. You don't need an awful lot of them. And all you're going to do is sprinkle them. Once you've done that, you're going to find a nice sunny spot in your home, possibly on a windowsill. And in about 3 to 4 days, you will see them starting to germinate. And what I mean by that is you'll see some lovely little green shoots, just like this little eggshell has started. So that's only about 2 days old. I hope you've enjoyed listening to me, and I hope you enjoy making your own cress.
Oh well, I really enjoyed seeing ways that I can plant seeds with things in my own house, and so if you have a go at that, then enjoy seeing your cress grow. Now, thank you so much for joining in with us today. We hope you had fun and you learnt something and you enjoyed seeing different ways that you can be creative at home at the moment. For any parents and carers watching, if you have any questions about anything we've said about Jesus or why we think he's so important, then please do drop us a message. If you head over to the Life Church Brackley website, you'll find an email address. So ping us through your question and someone would love to answer it. As for now, we're looking forward to seeing all of you next week. So take care and stay safe.